Let's talk about the difference between the dead sea salt versus regular sea salt. Is there a difference? Yes, there's a huge difference. Now, where do they get these dead sea salts? From the Dead Sea, which is located in a lake that borders Jordan, Israel, and the West Bank. Now, this is interesting. Even though the salt in the Dead Sea is 10 times more salty, it's actually less salty. Let me explain. It is more concentrated with minerals, that's for sure. But if we do a comparison to sea salt, for example, sea salt is about 90% sodium. Table salt is 98% sodium. Yet the salt in the Dead Sea is only 8% sodium. So it's way less in sodium, but it's very high in other minerals. Yet 60% of it is a combination between magnesium and potassium. So it's very low in sodium, very high in potassium and magnesium. So what does this mean? It means that it's not meant to be consumed. It's meant to be applied topically on your body, to the surface of your skin, whether in a sea salt mud bath or in your bathtub. So if you're going to use the sea salt in your bathtub, you just want to add a half of a cup because it's super concentrated. But the salt in the Dead Sea has some very interesting therapeutic benefits. Number one, it can decrease skin breakouts, as in acne. Number two, it increases skin hydration. It can decrease the aging appearance on your skin. It's great for pain, especially if you have rheumatoid arthritis, as well as arthritis, especially in your knee. It can enhance the healing process of your skin, and it's great for fibromyalgia. But you don't want to consume it. You want to consume regular sea salt, but not the salt from the Dead Sea. So if you're enjoying my content, which I hope you are, and you're applying this knowledge to your health, and you have a success, I'd really appreciate you sharing your success story. So click the link down below to my website where you can upload your success story so you can help inspire others.